Hello students, today we are going to discuss some last questions of exercise 9A and then discuss about compound interest. First, see the questions. First, I will solve question number 10. In 10 is given that simple interest on a certain sum is 16 upon 25 the sum. Find the time in year if the rate, percent and time is same. So in this case it is given that suppose principal is equal to x, therefore si equals to 16 upon 25 x. It says that 16 upon 25 of principal. Okay? Now rate is equals to time. And we can assume other variable other than this one. So I am using y. Means rate, percent and time, all these two are equal to each other. Question says that find the time in year if the rate, percent and time are equal. So as we know from formula, I write the formula this one. Simple interest equals to P into R to T. Simple interest is given. Principal is given, assume x, rate and time both are equals to y. By 100. Now, what we observe that there are two variables. So we keep one variable one side and other that side. So I am keeping 16x upon 25. This 100 is set comes and multiply. I am bringing x down equals to, in this case we have y square. It's a 64 equals to y square or y equals to the plus y side, but we are taking positive to 8. If it's a rate, then it's 8%. From this we can easily say that if it is rate, then rate equals to 8% per annum and time is equals to 8. This is your solution of question number 10. Now question number 11. Most interesting. In question 11, sum doubles itself. That principal doubled itself. So in this case, at a certain rate of simple interest, rate is not given, certain sum of money becomes double itself in 10 years. In what time it becomes triple of itself? Let's try to solve. Let principal equals to x. Si doubles itself, that is amount doubles itself, so Si must be same. Because in this case, amount double itself means principal plus Si equals to double. In this case, x plus x can double to this, amount is double. Since amount is double. And its time is given, it's your 10th year. Rate is not given, so rate equals to Si into 100 by principal P into time T. It's 10% per annum. Or this distance, this distance. So you have the rate. Now it says that in what time will it become triple itself, means three times. So the first part and for the second part. In first part, we have triple to Si equals to 2x. Since amount means triple 90. So this is, in this case SI equal to 10. Now we have rain. We found out the rain. We already found 10% per annum. So time equals to SI principal into rain. As we know that SI equals 2x into 100, but principal is x, rate is 10. 10, 20 years. 20 years. So this is your solution of question 11. Now move to question number 12, last question. This question number 12 is little bit toughest one among the all the 12. Not I can't say tough, it's easiest but lengthiest one. A part of this 1500 was lent at 10% per annum and the next part at 7% per annum. First we have to total amount of principal is 1500. Some part invest given with a rate of 10% and some part given at a rate of 7%. The total interest earned after 3 years is 396. Total interest SI is 396. So first find out others, find out the principal. So in this case, as we know that total sum in first part principal equals to x, we can assume principal is x, and in this case rate is your 10% per annum, time is your 3 years, so SI equals to x into, I am not writing the formula. It's 30x upon 100. This is for the first part. Then for second part, principal, I will 1500 is total one. X part is first part and second part, 1500 minus x. Rate is your 7% per annum, time is your 3 years. So from here I'm writing. This is SI first, then SI second equals to, it's a PRP, I'm not writing your formula. 1500 minus x is your principal, or 7 into time being 500. This is your 2 SI1, SI2. But total earned is given according to question. This one, SI1, 30x upon 100. Plus this one, 1500 minus x into, we can write 21 upon 100. It is 396. When we simplify, we have the LCM 100. It's a 30x plus. And say we have 1500 minus x into 20. In this case, we can easily take common 30x or whatever it is, but I'm not going to take common. It's to multiply. So by using distributive property, minus 21x. Equals to 396. 30x minus 20x, 1x, it's 9x plus am not going to solve these this one, but you can easily find out 9x plus, what is all it? 15 minus 15.3 minus 37 equals to 396 into 100. Therefore, you can write down 9x equals to 396 double 0 into 312. It's 9 315 double 0. You can easily write down over here. It's 100 9 minus 1 8 8100. 9x equals to 8100. So we can easily write down from there here we can write down 9x equals to 8100 or x equals to 900. This is the first part of the sum. Then second part we need to find out. Now this is the first part of the sum. Now second part, it says that what was the sum? It's a main question. What was the sum lent at 10% per annum? So first note on all this up to that one, this one, then come to the part. First part equals to 900, therefore second part equals to 1500 minus 900, which is 600. Now this is not answer, but this is to simplify. What was the sum lent at 10% per annum? What was the sum lent at 10% per annum? This is your first part, this is your sum. A is your first part, this is the complete solution. That's all for 9A. Let's move to the next check part, 9B, compound interest. We discuss and some short questions. Now, in this question, we are going, in this exercise, we are going to discuss about, it's 9B, about compound interest. Topic is your compound interest. What is the meaning of compound? In compound interest, we not calculate this interest of the three, all the time, complete time together. We divide them into year. Suppose we give some money for 3 years. So in case of compound interest, first we find out the interest for at the end of first year, then that interest and principal amount together and become the principal of the, so at the end of first year, what amount I have, that is the principal for the second year. At the end of second year, what amount I have, that is the principal for third year. And at the end, you can easily find out. This is more than the simple interest. We discuss this question by solving question number 1. It says that find the amount and compound interest on rupees 4000 at 12% per annum for 2 years compounded annually. Thus, this time we are not going to use that formula. We need to add some formula for compound interest to discuss at the end of the chapter and also in class 9. First, we try to find out by using simple interest formula, by SI formula. In this case, we are going to use by SI formula. SI concept. So, I am going to solve question number first of 9B, then this will clear to you. Amount and compound interest on 4000. Principle is given. A rate is given to you, 12%, time is given, it's a 2 year total time, but while solving, we use 1 year, so for first year, SI1, first year SI is your PRE, always remember time is 1, not at 2. Time is 1 because it is the word first year. It is 480. So, amount at the end of first year is 4000, that is your principal, plus that in SI it's a 4480. This is the amount at the end of first year, but for second year this amount is the principal. This amount is your principal. Principal for second year, P2. Principal for, in this case P1 is not given, P2 equals to amount A1, first year's amount, that is a 4480 rupees. 4480 rupees. And the same thing we have, R and P we have seen. R is 12%, time is 1 year. So SI2, second year's interest. It's a second year interest. It's a 4480 into 12 into 1 by 100. Find out. It's a 4480 equal 48 plus 9, it's a 57, 5 carry. 48 plus 5, 53. So, it is there, so we use this one. So, amount 2 is, second year's amount is your first, second year's principal plus that interest. It is your 0.678 plus 311, 1 carry, 4, 5, 9, 1, 10, 5. Rupees 5070.6. This is your this is your compound interest. I hope it's clear to you by using this concept. 9B says we use the SI concept only. We are not going to discuss the compound interest formula today. I am going to solve the last question and next question is on you. Question 4 is look like an English word, but simply like question number 1, you find out the compound interest at the till the end of third year, then you can easily give the answers of question number 4. Okay. What is the difference between the simple and compound interest on principal 7300 then after principal I have rate and time. Rate is 6% per annum and time is 2 here. If it's a always remember, in case of SI rate is 6% per annum only. In case of compound interest, we use the word compounded annually. So first find out the simple thing. Total, it's a total SP. When you find out SP, it's a P R T upon 100. It's given 7800. SP. Question says that difference in interest only. So this is for your compound interest. Now come to the compound interest, CI part, compound interest. So we know that P1 equal for first year 7300, rate is same, time is your 1 year, SI1 equals to 673 00 into 6 into 1 by 100. SI1, so amount 1 equals to 7300 plus 438. It's a 8377. This is amount 1. Now, for the second, year P2 equals to A1 equals to 7738. Rate is same, time is same. So SI2 equals to 7738 into 6 into 1500. First we multiply 8 6 48, 4 carry, 6 3's are 18 plus 4 22, 2 carry, 7 6 are 42, 42 plus 2 44, 2 carry, 7 6 are 42 plus 4 is 46, and then this 46, 4 and 64 by 128 will be the SI2. So amount 2 equals to this one. So let us solve. This is the amount. So what is the interest CI? It's A2 final principal minus principal. It's A202.28 minus it's 7300. It's 902.28. From there, we can easily say that simple interest is smaller than the compound interest. That's for all of you solve 9B125. Next day, discuss more questions. Thank you.